reveal the Queen on the application of Hemming and Westminster City Council?
To operate any sex shop, you need to apply for and obtain a licence. This case is about the licence fees charged by Westminster City Council to Mr. Hemming, trading as Simply Pleasure Limited. Westminster required him to pay on each application a fee made up of two elements. Firstly, a smaller amount in 2011-12, £2,667, relating to Westminster's costs of processing each application. And then also a larger sum, £26,435 in 2011-12, relating to Westminster's costs of operating and enforcing the licensing scheme, for example, by prosecuting unauthorised sex shop operators. The larger sum was refundable if an application failed. Mr. Hemming objects that this system is illegitimate under domestic and/or EU law. Under domestic law, he says it isn't covered by paragraph 19 of Schedule 3 of the Local Government Miscellaneous Provisions Act 1982, which only provides for, quote, an applicant for the grant, renewal, or transfer of a license to pay a fee. He says that the larger element is not something which an applicant can be required to pay. Under EU law, he relies on Article 13, subparagraph 2 of Directive 2006/123/EC, which is given domestic effect by Regulation 18.4 of the Provision of Services Regulations 2009, SI number 2999, and which provides that authorization procedures and formalities, quote, shall not be dissuasive, and any charges which the applicant may incur from their application shall be reasonable and proportionate to the cost of the authorization procedures in question and shall not exceed the cost of the procedures. Mr. M. Hemming argues, firstly, that the directive and regulations do not allow Westminster to recover costs of operating and enforcing the licensing scheme from licensees at all. Westminster must pay these costs out of the rates, council tax, and any other income it receives. In any event, he argues, secondly, that the larger elements mean that applicants were charged with sums exceeding the costs of the authorization procedures and formalities, and in the courts below, he succeeded on his primary case. Westminster now appeals, submitting that Mr. Hemming is wrong on all points. The Supreme Court, in a unanimous judgment given by myself, agrees that Westminster's system is authorized by paragraph 19, that is under pure domestic law. As to EU law, the Supreme Court also allows Westminster's appeal on the first point. The directive and regulations contain nothing to prevent Westminster imposing the reasonable and proportionate costs of operating and enforcing the licensing scheme on sex shop licensees. Article 13.2 and Regulation 18.4 merely regulate the charges that can be made in respect of the costs of licensing, of processing licensing applications. They do not apply to the costs which may be imposed on applicants whose applications succeed. It would therefore clearly be legitimate for Westminster to operate a system whereby applications for licenses were made on terms that the applicants must accompany their applications with a smaller amount to cover the costs of processing the application and, upon their application being granted, assuming it was, must pay a larger amount to cover the costs of administering and enforcing the licensing regime. The Supreme Court will make a declaration to that effect to establish the position for the future. That is not, however, the system which Westminster has until now operated. Westminster has operated a system whereby not only the smaller amount, but also the larger amount must be paid with the application, with the larger amount being refunded if and when the application fails. There is no evidence that this would have a dissuasive effect on applicants for sex shop licenses. Nonetheless, it is in the Supreme Court's view unclear whether, and if so, in what circumstances, this scheme might be said to involve a charge which Mr. Hemming incurred from the application, within the wording of EU law, in excess of the costs of processing the application, which would therefore be prohibited under Article 13.2 and Regulation 18.4. Because this point is unclear, the Supreme Court considers that it should make a reference to the Court of Justice in Luxembourg.